Mr. Speaker, it's my honor and pleasure to be in this august house this morning to answer the honourable member of parliament for Jama South questions on who the current owners of the aviation's land at Adenta are. Mr. Speaker, in answering this question, I would like to begin with a historical perspective of the issue. A brief on the site for remote receiving stations at Adenta in Accra. Mr. Speaker, the land measuring 632.74 acres was acquired compulsorily by the state in 1968 under the executive instrument EI-127 as state land, Accra Adenta Remote Receiving Station, instrument of 1968. Mr. Speaker, following the publication of the executive instrument, two expropriated landowners, Daniel Abochi Akpo, on behalf of the Labadi Agbawe family and head of the Adenta family, and the Kwetia Ahia, submitted claims for compensation in respect of 608.88 acres and 22.86 acres, respectively. Mr. Speaker, compensation was assessed and paid in full and final settlement in 1971 to the two claimants as follows. Daniel Abochi, on behalf of the Labadi Agbawe family and head of the Adenta family, 28,629 new Ghana cedis, an equivalent of 14,304.50 British pounds for 609.88 acres.
Mr. Speaker, I would like to read the first paragraph of the current situation and then pose a question from that. In a letter dated 1st December 2015, the Ministry of Lands and Natural Resources informed the Lands Commission of a cabinet decision to change the use of the land acquired under EI-127 for the Adenta Remote Receiving Station to other uses of public interest. Mr. Speaker, I would like to find out from the minister what the other public interest is in this matter.
Mr. Speaker, I think the rationale for every country in an emerging nation as ours is to improve on our developmental agenda and drive through a country that becomes a modernized country for the purpose of intergenerational equity. It was on that basis that the rezoning and redevelopment concept was instituted. Mr. Speaker, I'm fairly new to the ministry, but I've been briefed, and my understanding of the concept is that we must begin to make Accra look more beautiful and introduce some other concepts that were brought from other development countries into our modern country, Ghana. That, Mr. Speaker, was the rationale for the rezoning and the redevelopment of the business district.
The honorable member wants to know the public interest element. Honorable minister, if you answer the honorable member specifically, and I think it's well geared, what is the public interest content? So, honorable minister, if you can help to make it clear to me.
Mr. Speaker, the interest of every Ghanaian and public at large is to make sure that the country is acceptable to all citizens. Public interest in that regard, Mr. Speaker, is to make sure citizens of this country feel proud of their development agenda. The development of the business district, in my view, is a public interest because the public citizens of this country will view Ghana as a country that is emerging.
number five of the current situation and then pose another question. Five, directed that, the government directed that specific acreage ranging from 4.6 acres to 150 acres be allocated to 14 companies. Mr. Speaker, I would like to find out from the minister the names or particulars of such companies.
Why not?
Valwan Royal, 5.24. Allocation letter issued. Two, Hainful Dynamics Limited, 4.49. Allocation letter issued. Three, Ayok Holdings Limited, 18.06. Allocation letter issued. Four, Alive Pharmacy, 6.06. Allocation letter issued. Five, Matana Investment Holdings Ghana Limited, 20.67. Allocation letter issued. Six, Tiberias Company Limited, 55.33. Allocation letter issued. Seven, Anaina International Limited, 14.73. Allocation letter issued. Eight, Gossel Company Limited, 8.1. Allocation letter issued. Nine, Terapangai Resource Limited, 4.6. Allocation letter issued. Mr. Speaker, on assumption of my office, I have directed the Land Commission to cease issuing letters to the following companies that are still pending. Global International Limited, 14 acres. Ingmangu's Consult, 16.8. Romantic Furniture Manufacturing, 6. The Consortium, 44.
Order.
Africa Fiesta Limited, 18.6. Satis Construction Limited, 150. Parkway Developers Limited, 5. In total, Mr. Chairman, quite close to 200 and above acres. Direction was given to that effect for allocation letters not to be issued. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Municipal Assembly, that's the Adenta Municipal Assembly, or the Lands Commission has gone through any procurement process to procure the developers for the development, for the allocation of those developments.
Mr. Speaker, this technical issue, I'm not well familiar with it. I will get back to this house if I've been briefed properly. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
We will not allow ministers just to tell us, I don't have an answer now. But it means that within 2 weeks, you will come back and answer. Otherwise, questions may hang somewhere. So please, you will get ready. I'm just giving you a directive. You will get ready to answer what you don't have information on now within a period of 2 weeks. Every question will be answered once asked by an honorable member. Honorable, please.
Mr. Speaker, is the Honorable Minister of Lands aware that since April 2005, there's been an injunction on the land? 2005. And that the previous Lands Minister in the previous administration was injuncted and fined for contempt for the actions in the answer given, and that the Executive Secretary of the Lands Commission in the same matter was also found in contempt of court for pursuing these actions set out in the answer. Mr. Speaker, these have come to my notice.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I'm not aware of that development, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you.
the reasons that prompted him to stop the allocation of the over 200 hectares of land to the last list of companies that he stated. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you very much.
Yes, order. Honorable members, the quorum is imperative. We cannot just be shouting about that. Please.
With all due respect, Mr. Speaker, I don't think the minister heard my question. If you permit me,
honorable member, it's not for you to say we love you.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
And I think so. I'm the person to repeat it.
Very well, sir, Mr. Speaker.
Honorable minister, the question is, what informed the cancellation?
When the new administrations under the leadership of His Excellency Nana Akufo-Addo took office, structures were not immediately put in place. And so as a sector minister, I found it very unnecessary for operational decisions to be taken while the necessary administrative styles that need to grant approval are not fully in place. And that informed my decision to put hold on it.
Hello, Mr. Speaker. I read Article 25 and 6 of the Constitution. Mr. Speaker, under Article 25 says any property compulsorily taken possession of or acquired in the public interest or for a public purpose shall be used only in the public interest or for the public purpose for which it was acquired. Where the property is not used, that is 6, in the public interest or for the public purpose for which it was acquired, the owner of the property immediately before the compulsory acquisition shall be given the first option for acquiring the property, and shall, on such reacquisition, refund the whole or part of compensation paid to him as provided for by law, or such other amount as is commensurate to the value of the property at the time of acquisition. So, Speaker, from the minister's answer, no such first option was given to the owners from whom the property was acquired. I'd like to know whether the minister's attention was drawn to the constitutional provision and what has been done to comply with this constitutional provision.
These transactions were ongoing transactions before I assumed office. My attention had not been drawn to that constitutional provision.
Respectfully, I have your attention drawn to that relevant provision and advise this Honorable House further as to how you intend to deal with this problem holistically, including that reference to the Constitution as aforementioned. Thank you very much. Yes, any further questions? Honorable.
My question for the Honorable Minister refers to the second part of his answer and the current situation. Point 4. And Mr. Speaker, with your kind permission, I want to read. We are being told that the Ministry of Lands and Natural Resources engaged an island international company limited to provide infrastructure on the site and construct 100 executive apartments for government in exchange for 140 acres. Mr. Speaker, I want to find out from the Honorable Minister what kind of infrastructure portfolio was that limited liability company supposed to provide? One. And two, I would want to find out whether due technical diligence was conducted in order that Ghanaians were not shortened and that Ghanaians would have value for money in this transaction. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you very much. Honorable Minister, any due diligence made to ensure Ghanaians, in effect, have value for money in the transaction in court?
Mr. Speaker, it's difficult for me to determine immediately value for money in respect of the infrastructure projects being undertaken. But yes, indeed, Mr. Speaker, I visited the site and I have observed there were constructions of road and drainage, demarcations of the various plots. But as to the cost value reconciliations in terms of work done vis-a-vis the swap for land, Mr. Speaker, I'm not in a position to do that. And I'll get back to this house if details and information are be provided to my office. Thank
very,
you, Mr. Speaker.
Very well, Honorable Minister, you add this aspect also that in 2 weeks' time, you come and give honorable members a full account of the dynamics of value for money being public funds. Honorable.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, in the minister's response to the question for whole West, he indicated that it is technical, and for that matter, he's not in position to give answers to that effect. Mr. Speaker, is the minister simply telling us that he did not go through the documents that were made available to him, or that...
Honorable member, if that were a direct question, if it was apparent on the face of the original question asked, then we could say so. This is a supplementary. It being a supplementary, the Honorable Minister is entitled to go and advise himself and speak to the supplementary. Thank you. Any further question? Yes.
Minister, in a response to a question, said that he is not aware of an injunction placed on the land. Currently, we have been made to believe that there is still, the works are still ongoing, despite the injunctions. Mr. Minister, now that you've been made aware of an injunction placed on it by a high court of judicature, what do you intend doing?
Mr. Speaker, I'll call for the document, and if in need, the injunction is placed on that land, I'll consult my legal department for the necessary actions and direction.
Thank you very much.
Right, Honourable Speaker, please, I rise for your guidance. The direction to the Honourable Minister indicates that he must come back to this House in 2 weeks' time. 2 weeks from now is the 4th of April. Next week is 28th. Second week is the 4th of April.
Which and is my birthday.
Oh. happy birthday in advance, right or not? So Mr. Speaker, the business statement approved last Friday indicated that we will rise on the 30th.
Order.
We'll rise on the 30th, but I don't know if because of the importance of this matter and the fact that it's your birthday, we may have a special birthday session just to listen to the Lands and Natural Resources Minister.
Or so soon thereafter, which you know as a lawyer, that is when where something is adjourned to a non-dies in law, it means the earliest day thereafter, that matter is before the court or the appropriate. And that will apply accordingly. Yes, Honorable.
Mr. Speaker, it doesn't mean the whole parliament staff and your office doesn't operate. So I'm sure that your direction was to present it to the House. And if it is lodged in the clerk's office, it is deemed to have been served properly on Parliament. So, Mr. Speaker, I think your direction was in the right way. So the fact that we are not appearing here and sitting in a session does not mean, Mr. Speaker, the whole parliament comes to a standstill. Other than that, committees would even be sitting and I know the appointments committee and other committees will be sitting during that period. So, Mr. Speaker, I do not see anything wrong with your direction, and we wish you a happy birthday in advance.
Please, I don't want leaders to engage further on this, and I'll be glad if members will continue with the matter before us. But honourable minority leader, once on your feet. But I'll be very glad if, especially, I make a ruling on something, leaders included, we take the cue and let us continue with the matter before us. Otherwise, we shall be having discussions, which I don't appreciate too much. Honourable minority leader,
I would want an opportunity to further elucidate some clarifications from the minister, but I'm compelled to rise even after your ruling and guidance when my colleague...
Excuse me, honourable minority leader, you are asking your question.
But before then, Mr. Speaker, I want to respond to the deputy majority leader.
Honourable minority leader, I'm not certain that members are finished, and I'm going to call you. Honourable member.
Mr. Speaker, before my question, the majority leader has attempted to define what parliament means by our standing orders. The house refers to parliament. The office of the speaker is separate and distinct from parliament, even though Mr. Speaker is the chair of the house. She should not be misleading this house. If you have directed that the minister so comes to report back to this house, and in the interest of transparency, we will rather associate with your guidance that open house, plenary, he comes with the details and share with this house, and not the effort that the majority leader is saying that some letter be sent to some clerk or some committee, even while the house is on adjournment. But Mr. Speaker, I would want an opportunity to clarify. I have two questions for the minister. Honourable minority leader,
your turn will come with regard to the question. I appreciate very much your contribution. But I just want to, you don't see what's behind you. Your member is standing there. He wants to continue. Yes, honourable member.
Thank you very much, Right Honourable Speaker. Right Honourable Speaker, is the minister aware that part of the land is being used by the Ministry of Transport as we speak? And is the minister also aware that part of the same land is being apportioned per the cabinet directive to the Adenta municipality? And finally, Right Honourable Speaker, would he be kind to inform the House as to whether or not those who were allocated the land went through the right processes to acquire the land? Thank you.
Order. Honourable Minister, you are entitled to ask for a question to be repeated anytime you don't get it. Is the question clear to you? You may go ahead and answer. Otherwise, you may ask that it should be asked again.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, as to the issue of transparency in allocation of the land, I cannot tell. Transparency, my understanding, is go with competitive processes, fair in nature, and acceptable to all the stakeholders. I cannot tell the details as to how competitive it was, whether it was opened up for auction in terms of adverts, that I cannot tell. Mr. Speaker, as to the allocation with regard to the Ministry of Transport, I have spelled out the various acreages and names of companies that I found in the document handed over to me. Mr. Speaker, I have not come across Ministry of Transport in this allocation document I have. Maybe the name might have been, brought under one of these companies. These are some of the details that again will come to this August House.
Thank you, Honourable Minister. Honourable Minister, you will find all these out holistically as part of your return. And we are giving you 2 weeks to do so. The last question.
Mr. Speaker, on the floor, and to refer to the answer of the Honourable Minister number two, and with your kind permission, I read. In a letter dated 3rd December 2015, the Ministry of Lands and Natural Resources informed the Lands Commission of a cabinet decision to change the use of the land acquired under the Executive Instrument 127. Mr. Speaker, in addition to Article 20 of the Constitution, we'll refer to Article 11 of the Constitution, the hierarchy of law. An executive instrument is a creature of the Constitution. And I wonder whether a cabinet decision, a cabinet letter, could revoke an executive decision without the underlying executive instrument being revoked first. So I want to appeal to the Honourable Minister for us to have a look at this issue, because the basis of all these reallocations and all these reassignments is based on the cabinet decision, and whether that cabinet decision can revoke an executive instrument which is a creature of the Constitution. Respectfully, thank you very much, Right Honourable Speaker.
Order. Honourable Minister.
Mr. Speaker, my attention has been drawn to this. I'll consult with my legal department for further clarification.
Thank you. Honourable Minister, it means you have a lot of work to do within a minimum of 14 days that we are giving you. Honourable Minority Leader or Leadership? Leadership.
Mr. Speaker, may I refer the Minister to paragraph 1 of his own answer. The land measuring 632.74 acres was acquired compulsorily by the state. In your checks, the conditions for compulsory acquisition, then what was it met?
This compulsory acquisition was done in the 70s, I have stated earlier on. I'll check to see what actually prevailed, whether the terms and conditions of the compulsory acquisition were actually met.
The payment of compensation as captured in his paragraph one, last paragraph, is part of the condition precedent to satisfy the compulsory acquisition.
Honourable Minister.
Mr. Speaker, that is a partial index of the fulfillment, but it's not a conclusive evidence of a total fulfillment in accordance with the Constitution.
Mr. Speaker, may I refer to paragraph 20, item 3, for the Minister to answer what is the relationship between the Agbawe Plan Wer family of land and then what he refers to as the Labadi Agbawe family and Kwetia Ahia? What is the relationship?
Mr. Speaker, I think the word there, the relationship, is family. As to the details of how they interlink each other, I have no idea, Mr. Speaker.
Paragraph 2 says that the land was rezoned to other uses of public interest. And then he goes on to say in number 4 that Anaina International Company Limited was engaged to provide infrastructure on the site and construct 100 executive apartments for government in exchange for 140 acres. I want to find out from the minister whether the use to which the 140 acres will be put to will be in the public interest, because the land was originally rezoned in the interest of the public.
Mr. Speaker, I'll find out in due course if the 140 will also be subjected to the same land use plan.
I want to find out from the minister whether it then means that this company has not been directed specifically the use that it should put the 140-acre land to, that it was not part of the arrangement or the agreement with the company.
The Adenta Business District is a complete designed infrastructure, and any persons that want to work within that environment will need to conform with the design criteria. Mr. Speaker, I have not yet seen the detailed drawings of this particular company, and so I am promising the House that I'll check to see if the design of this company is also going to conform to the design. Mr. Speaker, it's interesting, of course, to note that no other structure in terms of design apart from the specificity of the design will be allowed to be built within that enclave. And so I'll check and see if this company's design also conforms to what is expected as part of the design.
Thank you very much for attending upon the House to respond to questions. I would want to recommend that you have a committee set up to examine the full dynamics of this issue, since the unanswered questions are many, so that on your next appearance, you can give this House a full picture of what is happening with regard to those lands. We thank you very much.